Hi, I'm Rose Willie from Encode Fashion. I have some tips to make designing fun and easy for you. Let's do it. Next, I'm going to arrange this pattern. So to arrange the pattern, we want this pattern right here, come over here to sew. Let me just put it next to each other. See right here, we want to sew this pattern to the left side of the pen, okay? And we want to sew this pattern to the right side of the pen. However, I'm going to label that pattern. First of all, I just made a mistake. Instead of select the whole pattern, I just select this internal line. I'm going to Control Z to undo that, okay? After that, once again, guys, click one on the page to deselect, because CLO try to help us out by leave it select every function that we do along the way. So you will hear all the time from me, click one on the page to deselect. Next, I'm going to click right here on this pattern and then move it over here to above these pants, okay? Now we just arrange this pattern to match which side we're going to sew to. Next, I'm going to label this pattern right and left. To do so, I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar and select annotation tool, click on it to select. Then I'm going to come over here, hover the mouse over that pattern, and you see this tapping box appear. Click on it. Then I'm going to tap in letter R. And I'm going to do the same right here. While this annotation tool is active, I'm going to click one right here to place my next typing box, and I'm going to type in letter L. After that, I'm going to adjust this label a little bit. To do so, I'm going to come over here to this edit annotation tool, click on one to select. Then I'm going to click on that letter and kind of move a little bit over here. Then click on this one to move. By the way, guys, it's barely show that this box, but if I zoom in closer, you see this box right here, that typing box, allow you to click on it and then drag to move to whichever location you want, right over here. Okay, so let me zoom out. Now, we just label these pattern pieces. Next, I want to measure this length because this is where we're gonna sew the zipper to, okay? We sew the zipper to here and here. To do that, I'm going to measure this internal line. To measure the internal line, it is easy. I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool, click on it, then click on that line right there. And as you can see, it is 16.21 centimeter, okay? So we want to add a zipper notch right here, 16.21. So to do that, I'm going to zoom in a little bit, okay? So number right here, 16.21, and we want that zipper notch right here, 16.21. To do that, I'm going to come over here to this notch tool, click on it to select, then come back to that line right there that we want to apply the notch. Hover the mouse over it and then right click. This will bring the notch window, and I'm going to show you a little tips here. So we have line one and line two. Line one is yellow, line two is blue. So depend on what direction of the length you want it from. Since for this example, we want the length of the direction is from the top down right here. So the length right here is in the blue line, and I'm going to type in 16.21 centimeter. That is for the zipper length, okay? Next, I'm going to come down here and click OK to confirm. I'm going to zoom in a little closer because I want to place another notch right here. This one, we don't have to measure the length of the notch because I am going to just place the notch on top of that point right there. Just click on it now. We just place another notch. So let me click one on the page to deselect, okay? To do that, I have to come over here to the transform pattern tool and then click one on the page to deselect. So I'm going to zoom in right here. Look, we have two notches already. I'm going to do the same on this opposite side. Let me zoom out a little bit and pan it to the left. Okay, so once again, come to this notch tool, click on it, and then come back over here to the pattern, hover the mouse onto that pattern that we are going to place the notch. Then hover the mouse over it, right click, and once again, line one, line two. We want from the top to the bottom, so we have to select line two, and the length is 16.21. After that, I'm going to come down here and click on OK to confirm. And once again, I'm going to zoom in a little more because we want to apply one more notch right here onto that point. And I'm going to click on it to apply the notch. Next, I'm going to come over here to the transform pattern tool, click on it. We want to get out that notch tool as well as click one on the page to deselect. Okay, so right now we created the zipper notch right there as well as the sewing notch because we want to sew this in notch right there after we sew the zipper onto the pant. It will make a lot more sense when I'm doing it, okay? So let me just zoom out a little more and pan it down a little bit. So next, I'm going to strengthen these pattern pieces before we are going to sew the zipper, okay? So to do that, I'm going to Command or Control plus letter A to select all these 2D pattern pieces. And then I'm going to just hover the mouse over that area and then right click. And I'm going to select Strengthen. So as you can see, a pattern pieces now turn all yellow. I'm going to click one on the page right here to deselect, okay? Thanks so much for watching, Designister. I hope you find this video useful and consider subscribing it for more awesome videos.